Good morning, friends. Here we are on Thursday in the what is today's date? Thursday, July 9th. I feel a little off because we're in this new schedule that we have. I'm writing. Thursday is my big sermon writing day because we film a church service, Sunday service, on Friday. So I'm taking some time here to get used to this new schedule, which I'm sure will get changed again once I get used to it. But it's sort of a good exercise for me to be writing my sermon earlier in the week. I had definitely in the COVID time, whereas normally Friday would be my sermon writing day, I had crept to the point that it was always Saturday. And that's tough on my family and everybody else to be writing a sermon on Saturday. And so this has been sort of a good discipline. We are reading, because of where we are in the daily office, we're also reading from the book of Matthew. And in Sunday service, we're reading from the book of Matthew. And as I was sitting down here planning, I was realizing that I sort of have competing Matthew dialogues in my head. So we're in Sunday worship, we're beginning a long stretch of parables. And I love the parables. Some of them are terribly difficult, total head scratchers. But what I love about them is that they impart a wisdom akin to poetry. They impart a truth akin to poetry. It's a very poetic, experiential, metaphoric truth that something that always is growing within us. Like, it never has a definitive ending point. And I like that. It sort of gives me hope for the way we as human beings grow and evolve throughout our lives, if all goes well. All right, my friends, on that note, we are not reading parables right now for our daily office. We're in the 24th chapter of Matthew, verses 1 through 14, and Jesus is already, it's in Holy Week, and so Jesus is on the road. Well, he's past the road. He's arrived at the destination of Holy Week, and so it reflects not that scene of sort of fecund learning, but zeroing in on his purpose and mission on the cross. So, on that note, let us begin our daily devotion. We start on page 137 in the BCP. No worries if you don't have it. I will lead you along. We begin always with a portion of Psalm 51. Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your saving help again, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. And now our reading, Matthew chapter 24, verses 1 through 14. As Jesus came out of the temple and was going away, his disciples came to point out to him the buildings of the temple. He asked them, "You see all these, do you not? Truly I tell you, not one stone will be left here upon another. All will be thrown down." When he was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, saying, "Tell us, when will this be, and what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age?" Jesus answered them, "Beware that no one leads you astray, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am the Messiah,' and they will lead many astray. And you will hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that you are not alarmed, for this must take place, but the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines and earthquakes in various places. All this is but the beginning of the birth pangs. Then they will hand you over to be tortured, and will put you to death, and you will be hated by all nations because of my name. Then many will fall away, and they will betray one another and hate one another. And many false prophets will arise and lead many astray. And because of the increase of lawlessness, the love of many will grow cold. But the one who endures to the end will be saved. And this good news of the kingdom will be proclaimed throughout the world as a testimony to all the nations. And then the end will come. It is a little bleak. The one who endures to the end will be saved. And this good news of the kingdom will be proclaimed throughout the world as the testimony to all the nations. So it certainly sounds like a very singular survival or what it means to be saved, the one. And it's possible to hear that in a general sense as, I mean, I think you could probably also say those who endure to the end. But then this good news of the kingdom will be proclaimed throughout the world. Yeah, this is a tough one, I will say. It's a tough reading. It's hard to know what to do with it, that's for sure. And, you know, that timeless quality of reading scriptures and understanding it. You know, when is the end? Is it now? And, you know, throughout history, you know, every generation of Christians, I think, has believed that theirs is the final generation. And I'm convinced that that's a kind of like a fool's quest. I think that we are here on earth to make God's kingdom manifest. Because the good news of the kingdom happens throughout the world as a testimony to all the nations. I think it's that's our job here on earth throughout the world, is to proclaim the kingdom. And as we were saying last night in Bible study, it happens so often more, it happens far more generously and effectively through our actions than through our words, is generally the truth of the matter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, we have been born anew to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Now, let us pray. Gracious God, we come to you in this day looking for hope, looking for strength, and looking for salvation now in our lives and this day. In the lives of those whom we love, and that we live out salvation with this life that you have blessed us with. Lord, we admit freely and often that we do not know what our purpose is sometimes, that we don't know the destiny that you have created us to live out, and we don't know your purpose within us always. But Lord, I pray that you help us in the midst of that mystery to live faithfully and to know your love and to proclaim your love as the good news of the kingdom, and to let it blossom and take root around us in all that we do. Lord, we pray for those who are suffering today. Pray for those who are sick and grieving. Lord, I lift up especially the Saz family, Nancy and Steve, and Patsy and Lulu. Lord, I pray that you be with them in their grief. And we commend to your mercy, Sally, and all those who have died, whom we love. And Lord, I pray that we will be together with them in your heavenly kingdom. Lord, we lift up all those who have been commended to our prayers. We pray for Randy, for Alice, Christy, Marjorie, Barbara, Roger, Bobby, Jen, Daisy, Leah, Elaine, Doug, Deborah, Joan, Kristen, Richard, Michael, David, Patricia, Richard, Suzanne, Joyce, Letitia, George, Wanda, Tammy, Sylvan, Robin, Sherry, Steve, Margie. In our congregational cycle of prayers this week, we lift up before you Jack and Karen, Nick, Steve, and Joyce. Lord, I pray that you give us strength where we are weak. You give us courage where we are faint-hearted and despairing. And Lord, I pray that you give us compassion and empathy where we are cold-hearted and not understanding of others and not sympathetic, not willing to put ourselves in the positions of others. Lord, I pray that you expand our understanding, not only in our heads, but also in our hearts. I pray for all those who are making decisions right now, for our public health, for our public good, for our common good. And Lord, I pray that you give us all the will to see ourselves as part of a greater whole. I give you thanks for the body of Christ here at St. Paul's and beyond St. Paul's. I give you thanks for bringing us into this great family through your love for us all. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And hear us now say the prayer your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. All right, my friends, I pray that you all go on to have a wonderful day, and that you live deep in the Spirit in all that you do. So take care, and I will see you soon. All right, everyone. Bye-bye.